बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम, अस्सलाम वालेकुम डियर स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू दी ऑनलाइन लेक्चर ऑन मैटलैब सिमुलेशन ऑफ कंट्रोल सिस्टम सीरीज़। सो टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस स्लाइडिंग मोड कंट्रोल बेस्ड ऑन बैक स्टेपिंग अप्रोच फॉर अ यूएवी टाइप क्वाड रोटर। दिस इज़ क्वाइट इंटरेस्टिंग पेपर विच यूटिलाइजेज स्लाइडिंग मोड कंट्रोल एंड इट बेसिस द स्लाइडिंग मोड कंट्रोल ऑन द बैक स्टेपिंग अप्रोच। Although it's from 2007, published in World Academy of Science, Engineering and Technology, International Journal of Mechanical and Mechatronics Engineering. So without further delay, let's get into this paper. So I'm not going to discuss the abstract, introduction and everything. I hope that you are a little bit familiar with how quad rotor works. So it has basically four motors, and the motors work in such a way that M1 and M3 are in opposite on opposite sides of the central mass, and they rotate in opposite directions with respect to each other to prevent impartment of any angular momentum on the quad rotor. Similarly, these two motors M2 and M4, they rotate in opposite direction with respect to each other. And the dynamics of the quad rotor, they involve three angles and three coordinates of the position. So the position will be x, y, z, and the angles will be roll, pitch and yaw angles of the quad rotor. And so if you look at the dynamics of the quad rotor, there will be dynamics of the roll, pitch, yaw angles, and then the dynamics of the x, y, z coordinates. This paper has very nicely written down the dynamics of the quad rotor in terms of state space. So you can easily write MATLAB code from these 12 states. So these are the three angles and followed by three position coordinates. Equation 18 is very important for MATLAB coding of quad rotor related to this paper. Another important is the equations are the equations of the rotor dynamics. So these are the dynamics of the rotors of the motors, which will also be part of our state space when we write the code for this paper. And then these are the so the control laws are based on the sliding surface. So here there are six sliding surfaces defined based on the difference between the desirable value of the state and the actual value of the state. And then the control laws finally are described here in equation number 24. And some constant values or values of the parameters are given here, but some of the parameters I warn you here that some of the parameters are not given in this paper. For example, this q1, q2, q3, q4, q5, q6 in equation 24, these are not given, but the authors have identified that these are positive numbers. So I have chosen all of them to be equal to 1. So k1, k2, k3, k4, k5, k6 equal to, all equal to 1, and q1 up to q6 all equal to 1. You can choose them to be any positive numbers, 2, 3, 4, 10, 20, whatever works for you. And you can actually do a little bit of analysis how the performance of the control varies with respect to variations of these parameters. So let's jump into writing the code for this. So as always, we create a function dx equal to, we call it qrbs, quad rotor backstepping. You can call the function any name. Then we write the values of the parameters. So m and d are given in the paper. You can see here that d is 25 centimeter, m is 486 grams. So our unit will be kilograms and meter. So we add appropriate multiplication factors. So similarly, we keep on writing. So this is omega bar. Omega bar is the function of rotor velocities. So it is given here. So here omega bar is the function of rotor velocities. Omega 1, omega 2, omega 3, omega 4 are the angular velocities of the motors in the quad rotor. So OB, that will be x13, x14, x15. So these four will be the state, the rotor velocities will actually be the states in our simulation. with the state dynamics as given in the paper. So these are some values of beta 1, beta 2, and these are also given in the paper. And then the value of G is, everybody know the value of G. And C is equal to, C, I don't remember that it is given in the paper. So whatever constant is not given in the paper, I have assumed to be equal to 1. Then IX, IY, IZ are also given in the paper. Then these constants are also provided in the paper. These two. Then JR is also given in the paper. Then these equation of A1, A2, A3, these are given under the, let me go to the state space model, which should be in the next page. So this is this, these are the equations for A1, A2, A3 up to so on A11. So we'll keep going, A4, A5, A6 and up to so on this A10. All of these equations are given here, equation 19. So we write up to A11, and B1, B2, B3 are also given here. And then we have to, in the end of our simulation, we have to test the controller against some desirable trajectory. So in my case, I have selected the desirable trajectory to be like all the angles are desired to be zero, roll pitch yaw. I am not trying to control roll pitch yaw. I'm trying to control the position of the quadrotor. So x position will be following sine curve, y position will be following cosine curve. So this will be a circular motion. And this is the desirable function for x position, and this is x derivative. So the desirable state vector, it has 12 entries, and each of the entries is the desirable value or function for one of the states. So this is for phi dot, theta, theta dot, psi, psi dot, x. So desirable x is sine of t, and desirable x dot is cosine of t, which is the derivative of sine of t. Desirable y is cosine of t, and desirable y dot is the derivative of cosine of t, which is minus sine of t. Then desirable z is 0.1 t, so quadrotor should also gradually go upwards, and its derivative is 0.1, of course. So this is result in a spiral trajectory. So quadrotor will be spiraling upwards, as we will see at the end of this simulation. And then this is so I have defined some variables z that I will tell you in a minute, but this is the derivative of the above vector. So these are the desirable values of all 12 states, and these are the derivatives of, so for example, sine, the derivative of sine is cosine, so derivative of cosine is minus sine, and so on. Derivative of 0.1 of t is 0.1, and derivative of constant 0.1 is 0. And then z variables are defined for the sliding surfaces. So these are the intermediate variables. So z variables are the difference between the desirable values of the states and the actual values of the states. So I'm going to define the z variables as prescribed in the paper. So for example, this is just initialization of z. So first of all, I define z from 1 to 11, so odd z values, so 1, 3, 5, 7, 9, 11. So this will be defined by z is equal to x desired minus x, so as here, and then I will then define the even values 2, 4, 6, 8, 12 for z, and those will be x desired dot of previous value minus z of previous value. So this is how we define z as prescribed in the paper. All right, let's keep going. So go back to our file. So next we define some, so C phi and C t are some constants which are again not given in the paper, but they are used in the dynamics. For example, if you go here, so this is C phi and C theta. These are some constants. These values are not given in the paper, so I assume them to be 1. Then this is V1, V2, V3 and V4 are the inputs to the motors. So there are 4 motors, so there will be 4 inputs to the motors. So usually we use DC motors in the quad rotor, so this will be like the voltage input to the motor. So this is proportional to Z variables. So V1 and V3 will be 1/2 Z1. So V1 will be 1/2. So we will be using the equation 22 in the paper to define V's, which are input. So since there are only 4 motors, we only need V1, V2, V3 and V4. Although equation 22 suggests that we can have 12 values here, but we don't need 12 values. So V1 will be Z1 square over 2, V3 will be Z3 square over 2, V2 will be V1 plus Z2 square over 2 as prescribed here for the even values of V, and then V4 will be V3 plus Z4 square over 2, as you can see here. Okay, so next we define the we start defining the controls, because the sliding surface SV is simply equal to Z2 and we have already defined Z2, so we don't need to separately define sliding surface S equal to Z2. That will be the waste of a line of a code. So I just use Z2 as the sliding surface. Z4 is the second sliding surface. Z6, Z8, Z10 and Z12, all of these are like 6 sliding surfaces. So for example, if you go to this U2, 1/B1, so into minus Q1 is not given in the paper, so I've assumed it to be equal to 1. Sine of SV is sine of Z2, because SV is equal to Z2. Minus K1 SV, so again SV is Z2 and K1 is not given, so I've assumed it to be equal to 1. And then again the whole equation is taken from the things given already in the paper. So x phi desired double dot is the in the x dot vector. So x double d vector, this is the value of the phi dot. So phi dot dot will be in the so anyways it will be 0 in this case, but you should know, in case it is, if it is non-zero, then phi desired double dot is phi dot like x2 in the second term in the x double d. So this is second term in the x double d, and then there is the alpha 1. Again I have assumed to be equal to 1 because I couldn't find the value of alpha 1 in the paper. So x desired phi desired is x desired 2, and then phi desired dot is x desired 2 and minus x2, which is the actual value of phi dot. And similarly we can define the next control equation, U3, which is this one. And in here the Z4 is the sliding surface S theta, and next U4, where Z6 is the sliding surface S psi. And then next is U1. So U1 is, I have defined U1 before UX and UY, because U1 is used in UX and UY. In the paper you can write UX and UY before U1, but in the code you have to define the U1 before you define UX and UY. And also UX and UY depend upon U1, whether it is zero or not. So we will be using if condition. So U1, same equation as here in the paper. This S of Z is Z12. And then we have, so if U1 is, so paper does not tell you the value of UX and UY if U1 is equal to 0. It only tells you that UX and UY is this expression if U1 is not 0. So I've assumed that whenever U1 is 0, UX and UY is 0. It's quite typical in control systems. So that's why maybe authors did not bother mentioning that. And then you have UX and UY. These equations are the same as this UX and UY equation. SX is Z8 and SY is Z10. Then we go to keep going, in the code. Then we go into the writing of the state space equations. So we go up into here, the state space model, x1 dot equal x2. So we write this model, so x1 dot equal x2, and then x2 dot equal this whole thing, a1 times x4 x6 plus a2 times x2 square and so on. And then we write x3 dot equal x4, x4 dot equal to the whole this equation of x4, and then x5 dot x6, and similarly we keep going until the x we reach x12 dot, which is this a11 times x12 and so on. So after writing the states, now we are not done yet, we still have to write the dynamics of the rotors. So the model chosen for the rotors is as follows. So we have to write this model as well. So we go to let me push it a little bit here. So this is the model, omega 1 dot is equal to b times v1 plus minus beta naught minus beta 1 into omega 1 minus beta 2 into omega 1 square. So in my code, omega 1 is x13, so b times v1 minus beta 0 plus minus beta 1 times x13 and so on. So remember that we have this omega bar, which is x13 minus x14 plus x15 minus x16, which is also used in the state dynamics in the first 12 states as well. So this is important. So x14, similarly, this is omega 2, and then x15 and x16, all very similar equations as depicted here in the paper. And finally, now we are ready, and this whole code is done. So you return all of this x1 dot, x2 dot, up to so on, x16 dot, as we always do, into the this dx variable, which is the output of the function. And now we are ready to call this function, and we can call this function using another file, tx ode 45 qrbs 15 seconds, and then you can give zero initial conditions all the 16 states, and then you can compare that. This I have used the plot 3 command. Plot 3 is a three-dimensional plot of x, y, z coordinates. So x coordinate is state number 7, y coordinate is state number 9, and z coordinate is state number 11, and I'm going to compare it with the desirable trajectory, which is x will be following sine t, y will be following cosine of t, and z will be following 0.1 into t. So just run this, and here you can see that the desirable and the actual trajectories are following each other. They start off from different initial conditions, but eventually the tracking is about perfect. And you can also plot other different things. For example, you can plot this TX7 versus its desirable value. So let me close this and plot this. So you can see here that this is following the desirable value, and similarly you can see whether the y position coordinate is following its desirable value or not, and similarly you can see if the this t is following its desirable value or not. So all they are all following their desirable values. So that is all for now, and I hope that this video will help you in getting started with your quadrotor research. And also please check out the official MATLAB YouTube channel. They also have posted recently a good video on quadrotor simulation. So please do check that out. Thank you very much. That is all for now.